4 days since that deadly tornado hit Moore, Oklahoma. Within hours of touchdown, a team of KETV News Watch 7 journalists were there. While the devastation is overwhelming, so is the spirit of the people who live there. Tonight, Todd Andrews and photojournalist Ashley Nodgaard take us through the disaster zone.
When it comes to lasting images of the devastation in Moore, Oklahoma, perhaps the most graphic is this, the Moore Medical Center. Monday's EF5 tornado nearly tore the building in two, whipping off much of the second floor, breaking dozens of windows, and leaving debris scattered about the parking lot. It seems impossible that all the patients and staff here survived.
Happened, drove down, and we went through the back of this neighborhood searching for people. Thank goodness, you know, we didn't find any.
Travis Mayberry was among the residents surveying the damage here Tuesday as first responders, including the search and rescue team from Nebraska, moved in.
Remember, the theater was always on the south end.
Another image we will always remember, the hundreds of vehicles that were picked up by the storm, twisted into nearly unrecognizable shapes, and slammed into the ground, oftentimes hundreds of feet from where their owners had parked them.
To look at that wreckage, you wouldn't think anybody crawled out of there alive.
Lisa Jackson found her car an entire parking lot away from where she'd left it. In the wasteland that remains, some vehicles sit alone, others in pileups, and several inside what used to be houses.
Not mine, not mine. It must belong to somebody on down that way or something. Seems like stuff just swirled around.
Houses like Rick Brown's, one of countless homes leveled by the twister. We watched as he and his son combed through the aftermath, recovering whatever they could.
I'm not worried because I got insurance. Good insurance.
Their senses of humor at least intact.
My ex-wife's got one of the best sellers made, and I don't even have one.
Down Telephone Road to the south, we found a story right out of a disaster movie. Mark Ellard, who rode out the storm in his bedroom closet, now the only part of his house left standing.
And all of a sudden the roof went, and when the roof went, I saw it go over. We've always thought that that would be the safest place to go, and as it turns out, it was.
And those who lost their homes weren't the only ones left with nothing. Business owners took a major hit, too.
And yes, that's a bowling ball on the floor of what used to be a very popular bowling alley right here in the middle of Moore, Oklahoma. And as you can see, this place was literally laid flat.
Here, manager Tony Lanning started picking up the pieces, trying to ignore the mess of steel and wood and masonry right next to him.
Just devastating looking is really all you could say. The only word describes it.
Sure enough, as quickly as the storm came and went, relief was on its way. Our cameras were there as thousands of volunteers poured into town from all over America, from students with tools to professionals with heavy equipment, all of them with one goal, provide all the support they could, something that left residents here with grateful hearts.
Down the street, there's water, there's food. It's just, the outpour has just been, it's just been remarkable.
And that sentiment ties into something we saw every day in Oklahoma. 33,000 residents may have been affected by the storm, but they refused to call themselves victims. This community defines the word resilient. For these people, the beginning of this week called for courage amid catastrophe, while the end of the week demanded resolve amid uncertainty. In the end, they've shown the world a lesson in both.
That's what's pushing us, you know, just to stay positive and, you know, look forward to tomorrow.
Todd Andrews reporting, and of course our thanks to photojournalist Ashley Nodgaard as well. In all, 24 people were killed in the storm.